Hello everybody, my name is Alphanephalon and welcome back to Dragon Age Origins. I just had a bitch of a time getting this shit to start up. Not the game, my
Shale of House Kadash. Is that who I once was? I find this difficult to believe.
Believe it, sister. You're tall for a dwarf.
I am not a dwarf. Or at least, I'm not a dwarf any longer. If I was this Shale of House Kadash, as Caridin said, there must be some evidence of my existence remaining. I must find it.
Think something will trigger your memory?
I need to know that this is the truth, and not simply believe. What Caridin said, it has allowed me to remember one thing. I believe I know where Kadash Tig is.
We can go there if you like.
Its offer is appreciated. I will mark the location on its map. If we can journey there soon, I am most curious as to what we will find.
Okay, talk to Wynn, because I'm pretty sure she has something to say.
Thank
now.
Thank you so much.
This is about an errand, I assume?
Yes. You led me to an errand. You persisted, even though I was sure all you were going to find was a dead end.
It always feels good to get resolution.
I will never be able to repay you for what you've done for me. Finding an Oghren allowed me to bring that chapter of my life to a close. I feel free. A great weight has been lifted off my heart. This moment, it feels like the moment before the sunrise, when all the world is still, holding its breath, waiting for first light. I can stop thinking about my past and look forward to the future. Thank you, my friend. You will always have my gratitude.
So
what's on your mind?
Have you changed your mind about Morgan and me?
I have watched you for a time, and perhaps I was wrong. There seems to be something special between the two of you.
Oh, yeah.
It doesn't happen often, but I see her smile to herself sometimes when she watches you.
Does she? Aw, how sweet. I have to tease her now.
I think I was too harsh in my judgment before, and I am sorry.
You wanted the best for both of us.
What you have may not last forever. Death and duty may part you, but love's worthiness is not diminished because of that. I should have seen this before. Instead, you learn to cherish every precious moment that you spend together, knowing that it may be the last. And for those of us watching, well, it brings warmth to these old bones to know that something so beautiful can be found in the midst of chaos and strife.
Okay, supply crates. Gems for the dwarves. Sapphires. Malachites. Amethysts. Topazes. I can sell the other crap. Elf roots. Deep mushrooms. Death roots. Runes. Expert. Journeyman. Novice. Coins for the knights.
We are...
Do I have 30 sovereigns? I have 54
sovereigns.
Better
with every step you take.
Alright, drop in 30 sovereigns. Shit.
You'll have the best equipped force since, well, ever.
There you are. Wanted to talk to you.
Now this is a weird glitch that comes from this armor, putting it on Oghren. Maybe it's just any armor on Oghren. Occasionally, when he turns to talk to you, he'll still have the helmet on. What about?
You and I, we've... You know how sometimes you spend time with people and things?
I love you too, Oghren.
What? Keep your hands where I can see them. Sheesh. Can a man address a friend without getting all weird? I was just asking a favor. You had to go all that on me.
A favor, what is it?
I was thinking, I do know some people out here on the surface. A person, actually. A girl I knew in Orzammar, before I left, obviously.
A girl you knew, or a girl you knew?
What? Oh, you mean, were we rutting? After Bronco left for the Deep Roads. Name's Felsie. She was a fiery one. I'm sure she's forgiven me by now. Thought maybe I'd track her down, see how she's been living.
Wait, you cheated on Bronca?
Me? Cheat? Ah! That iron-thighed shrew had left me long before. And she cheated on me with that tramp Hespeth. I grant you, I didn't find out about that till after, but... Hey, truth is truth. Anyway, she left for the surface a year back, and I haven't seen her since.
Why did she leave?
What? Why are you asking me? I didn't do anything. Last I heard, she was gonna live with her mother on the surface, near some lake. Clean Bad Lake, was it? Yeah, I sod it, I don't remember.
Clean Bad? You mean Lake Callenhad. We can go there.
No, I think it was Clean Bad. I remember because I thought, yeah, that's right, dirty good. Clean bad.
Yeah. Oh, Oghren's delight.
But thanks for offering to take us there. You're a good friend, Warden. Now, what was it you wanted to say?
Can you teach me to fight like you do?
You want
to
be a berserker?
Holy crap!
Thought I'd never see the day. I'll teach you. Just be ready. To be a berserker, you have to face your own inner rage. Let the spirit of battle take over. And all that dust. There's a whole pile of philosophical rot that goes behind it. But the bedrock is this. Get real mad and kill things.
Please then, teach me.
I can teach you what gets my hackles in a twist. But no one can tell you what'll set off that killing rage in you. Finding that is the key to berserking. Once you got that... I tell you, the ladies love it when you're all mysteriously angry for no reason. Trust me.
Yeah. Maybe Dwarven.
You're a quick study, Warden. You must have been seriously steamed up about something for a long time.
Tell me more about berserkers.
What the sod is there to know? You get mad, you fly into battle, and things die. It's pretty simple. The hard part is getting in touch with your rage. We all learn to hold that back. It's why we don't kill every duster who looks at us sideways. You need to shut that off. For some people, being in battle is enough. But others have to think about something. Violence, monsters, nobles, your wife, whatever.
Your wife?
Aye, especially my wife.
Just thinking about it works?
For most berserkers it does. Several years ago, I worked with a berserker on one expedition who just couldn't work himself up. We had to kick him in the stones before he could get going.
Like, damn. Why would you want to fight that way?
Why not? When you fight, you get mad. By the stone, it's a sodding tactic to enrage your enemy so he makes a mistake, right? Berserkers grab that anger and drink it like it's yesterday's ale. Then we turn it against our foes and watch the limbs fly.
Alright. Yeah, Andrew. Ogryn's not the smartest guy around, but he knows battle and ale. He knows those two things very well. Let's talk about something else.
I'm listening.
Where are you going?
I'd like to know more about you.
What about?
Are you sure you're fine with what happened with Bronca?
Oh, sure. I'm fine with it. I mean, she was a real firebrand between the sheets, but a bit soft in the skull, you know what I mean? Explains why she left, anyway.
So you're not broken up over it?
I swear to this stone, the next time someone asks me that, I'll write my name in bruises on their ass. Ancestors, take me. You people whine like tea kettles around here.
I'm trying to figure out the,
Come to talk to old Oghren, have you? Don't know why.
I'm trying to think of what it is you have to say to him to make him mention the, Bronca and Hespeth rutting on the floor. And he was like, excuse me a minute, I have to go do something. What's wrong, Oghren?
Nothing. I'm fine. Just, I got a hornet in my eye is all. Did you want to talk about something?
Yeah, I'd like to know more about it.
What about?
How do you like the surface?
It's sodding great. At first I was a little queasy with all that air, but there's just so much of it. No one has any idea who you are or what you're doing.
Oh no, wait, this
way ale. Oh, who'd have thought? Ale made with grain. Aye, the surface is great. It's like a big, bright world of filth without a ceiling. My kind of place. Hey, let's go find something to kill, huh? All this talk makes my hands twitchy.
Okay, it's then that he mentions ale made with grain. It's at the end of the game where he
pull
mentions
up a drink, Warden.
How bad
join me in my sodding hole.
Something bothering you?
Just tired is all. Did you want to talk about something?
I'd like to know more about.
What about?
You miss Orzammar?
What? Miss Orzammar? Are you mad, in addition to being ugly? They treated me like a puddle fly back there. I'm never going back.
Let's talk about something
else. All right.
Talk more later. Oh, come on, there's more to talk about.
Just leave me alone, Warden. Seriously.
Why, are you upset about something?
Upset? I don't get upset. I get drunk. Did you want to talk about something?
Not doing more.
What about?
What is it like to be a warrior in Orzammar?
You get a sword or an axe, and are told to go out and defend your city. It's the best thing in the world. That is until you try to live in the city you saved.
What do you mean?
I mean, they train you to kill, teach you to harness your rage at the first noise you hear, then try to set 100 sodding rules about it. Like those provings. Ancestors show their favor through the strongest arm, right? So why so many rules saying how to fight, and when you win, and not to bloody kill? Killing's what swords are for.
Fighting without killing is a skill of a true warrior.
If that's how you feel, I'll try that out next time the Darkspawn are chewing on your leg. This makes me cranky. Don't you have any other inane questions?
Actually, let's talk more some other time.
All right.
We'll talk more later.
All right, then.
Deke approves by one. Okay, so let's see. Okay, let's see. Gifts. That goes to Zavarin.
Excellent taste.
And that's everyone there. Now, to sell some stuff.
Something you need?
Then get on my way.
I'm
sell. Hold on to that, because I still don't know if I'm keeping it. And I'll keep that sword just in case, or, you know, just for the heck of it. Get rid of that, get rid of that, get rid of that. Oh no, I didn't show you where to get the boots. Shit, I gotta go back to Orzammar. Oh, and I finally remembered what gloves I usually give to Liliana, so I'm getting rid of these pushback strikers. I just can't remember where to get them. Catriel's Grasp. You remember where that is? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, Grandmaster Lightning Rune. That's exactly the kind I need. So that's that. Sell. Okay, Sandal?
Enchantment?
Grandmaster Lightning Rune! That is cool. And yeah, you can actually see the frost along with it, I think. Unless that's just part of the... No, I think the frost just covers more. It sucks that you can't see the fire with it all three at the same time. Okay, so. Time to level up. Morgan. You need plenty of health to be a good blood mage. Stan, you just need more constitution because you're a wimp. Alistair. More constitution. Actually, no. I want to start putting stuff into your dexterity so you can eventually get the shield mastery. But for now, death blow. Lelianer. Oh, constitution. Summon spider. Okay, so Fang, you just do your thing. And Zevran, constitution. Dueling. There we go. Round of talking.
You know, I've been thinking.
What have you been thinking about?
Back when we left Goldanna's, you told me I needed to look out for myself more than I do. I'm beginning to think you were right. I need to stop letting everyone else make my decisions for me. I need to take a stand and think about myself for a change, or I'm never going to be happy.
Alright, it's about time, I say.
Then from this point on, I'll be looking out for myself more. I should have done this a long time ago. I just wanted to thank you. You've been a great friend through all of this. The one bright spot in everything that's happened.
Right, you're a good friend too.
Let's go. We've got a lot left to do. Ask away.
I had another dream about the Archdemon.
Yes, me too. And I got the feeling at the end there that it saw us, was aware of us, whatever you want to call it.
I'm thirsty.
Just been my imagination, I suppose. What do you think?
I think that Archdemon needs to die. Quickly.
Well, short of waltzing through the entire Darkspawn horde and tapping it on the nose, I'm not sure just how we're supposed to do that. But killing the Archdemon is the general plan, I understand. Good to have you on board. I guess one thing is certain, at least, isn't it? It's official. This is a blight.
Anything else?
Ask away. Of course.
What was it like to be a Grey Warden with all the others?
I didn't know them for very long. But I guess it was longer than you. You never met them all, did you? They were quite a group. Actually, they felt like an extended family.
Did I get this conversation with him already?
From our former lives. We also laughed more than you'd think. There was this one time... Well, you probably don't want to hear stories about men you didn't know.
That's what I'm wondering. Were there any elves amongst them?
Just one, A man named Terramel. He kept to himself, mostly. I got the impression that his life before the Grey Wardens was unpleasant. There was one Grey Warden who came all the way from the Anderfels. What was his name? Gregor. He was a burly man with the biggest, fuzziest beard you've ever seen. And the man could drink. He drank all the time, but he never got drunk. Finally, we all made a pool to see just how many pints it would take to put him under the table.
Well, I could have outdrank him. Yeah, I don't remember that option.
Oh, I honestly doubt it. You might have tried, but this fella had a supernatural constitution, I swear. Anyhow, we never did find out. He said he'd drink a pint for every half pint that the rest of us drank. He was still going by the time the rest of us were passed out. I'm told that Duncan walked in later on and saw us all passed out from one end of the hall to the other, and Gregor still drinking. Duncan laughed until he nearly... until...
I'm sorry. This must be hard for you.
Yes, I suppose so. I thought I was done with this, but... it just struck me that I have nothing to remember Duncan by. Nothing at all. There's no body, not even a token of his, that I could take with me. That must sound really stupid to you.
You have your memories of him.
I just would have liked something of his to take with me, that's all. Well, there's no use in moaning about it, is there? He's gone. Let's just go.
All right, talk to Liliana.
Oh, hello. Is there something you wanted to talk about?
Oh yeah, that's right. I never talked to her after dealing with Marjolaine. I'd like to talk about what happened today.
It's nothing. I'm fine. I'm just thinking.
What about?
I can't get what happened out of my head. I'd been in Lothering for years, and she still thought I was plotting against her. She didn't trust me. Maybe she never did. She loved me when she could use me and control me. And now that she can't, she wants me dead. It hurts to realize that I never really knew her.
Is there anything I can do?
You're already helping so much by listening to me. I knew she was ruthless, but I didn't know how far she could go. She is self-serving, cruel. She uses people, then discards them. But that's how she survives in the life she leads. What if she's right? What if we're the same? I should just have stayed in the Chantry.
She would have attacked you there eventually.
Maybe, but that is not the point. I was a different person there. I forgot my life as a bard while I was in the cloister. I felt safe. I didn't have to watch my back all the time. That's what made Marjolaine the person she is, don't you see? It ruined her. It will ruin me too. It's already happened. When we killed her, I enjoyed it. Seeing her dead gave me satisfaction.
It's only human. Don't punish yourself.
But that is no reason to rejoice over her death. That is what she would do. I don't want that. What we're doing. What we've done. Hunted men down. Killed them. Part of me loves it. It invigorates me, and this scares me. I feel myself slipping.
You're not slipping. This is who you are.
I admit that I took great pleasure in the intrigue back in Orlais. It was dangerous and chaotic and exciting, but it destroyed my life. I thought the Chantry showed me another path. I thought I was done with this life. Am I wrong?
All you were doing in the Chantry was running away.
There is this thought that floats into my mind constantly. That I lie when I say the Chantry gave me peace, when in truth it bored me. Here, with you, knowing the freedom of the road and the uncertainty of tomorrow, I feel alive again.
Then stop running scared from it.
I would like to be alone for now. I have many things to consider. Thank you for listening to me. Do you remember our discussion?
Yeah, it was just 2 seconds ago.
I just wanted to tell you that I thought about what you told me, and you were right. I didn't want to admit it, even to myself, but those years in Lothering, I yearned for the freedom and the recklessness that I knew in Orlais. The Maker made the world beautiful, but he also made it dangerous. To really experience it, I have to embrace this, not hide away in some nunnery.
No more running away, all right?
Sometimes, it takes another to show us the truths we hide from ourselves.
It was my pleasure.
I'm glad I left Lothering in your company. You have proven a true friend, and I thank the Maker for you.
There we go. Besides, the game didn't ruin her life. Marjolaine did.
Look at you. Your weary stance. The dark circles under your eyes. Poor man. All this constant walking has gotten to you. Do you know what you need?
I don't remember getting this. And I'm worried. Oh, this I have to hear.
My thought is this. We retire to your tent, and I show you the sort of massage skills that one only learns growing up in an Antivan whorehouse.
I'm not complaining, but not in this, not with this character. No, absolutely not.
Why? Because you are a man? Surely we are past such superficial definitions. We travel together, do battle together. Is there any reason we may not also take pleasure in each other's company?
There is someone else.
Ah, my mistake. Say no more then. I take it all back.
Oh, shit! Disapproved 25. Shit! I need to get friendly with him again.
What say you?
Can I answer some questions?
By all means.
Frit.
What say you? Again? I'm game.
Frit. There's gotta be a way to get his approval back up a bit. I don't want to risk him turning on me. It's because I wouldn't fuck him.
You called.
I have a question.
I am hardly surprised.
Do you find Ferelden very strange?
To put it lightly, no one has a place here. Your farmers wish to be merchants. The merchants dream of being nobles, and the nobles become warriors. No one is content to be who they are.
Don't the Canary ever want to change their lot in life?
What does that accomplish? The farmer who buys a shop is never a merchant. He is always a farmer turned merchant. He carries his old life with him as a turtle carries its shell.
Maybe he was meant to be a merchant.
Meant by whom? And if that were indeed his purpose, why did that mysterious source of meaning not make him so to begin with?
You think birth should determine your destiny?
Destiny? Destiny is superstitious nonsense. Life is not a journey that ends with you arriving or not arriving at the proper destination. Life is what you do. Life is the duties you fulfill.
You don't think happiness is important?
You can learn to find it in doing your duty, in serving your people. There is no need to search for it. Shall we move on?
Sound a bit homesick.
Perhaps. It's strange to be in a crowd and hear a language that is not your own. To see faces that are and aren't like yours. I miss the smells of Saharon. Tea and incense and the sea. Ferelden smells of wet dogs.
You left out rotting garbage.
True. I was trying to forget that part. Shall we move on?
Is there anything you like about Ferelden?
There is interesting food here. You have a thing. It doesn't have a word in the Kunari tongue. Little baked things, like bread, but sweet and crumbly.
Cookies?
Yes. We have no such things in our lands. This should be remedied.
I'll keep that in mind.
Shall we move on?
I want to discuss something you mentioned.
Speak, then.
What do you mean your mages are beasts?
I misspoke. They are not beasts. Beasts learn eventually.
You Kinari are remarkably closed-minded folk, aren't you?
It keeps your stupidity from getting in. Is there some reason you insist upon discussing this?
It's a subject of concern to me.
You live in this world just as I do. You already know what magic is.
What, did a mage kill your puppy or something?
Something. There is no use talking of this. We should move on.
Oh. I never actually picked that option for him. So he does have a personal reason for not liking mages.
Very well.
Mages aren't as dangerous as you say.
Clearly your chantry agrees.
Not all mages turn to blood magic.
My people have a tale. An Ashkari walked among the fields once, observing the laborers at work. Flax bloomed all around him, the color of still water. The air rippled like a curtain. As he stopped to examine a blossom, a bee stung him on the hand. The Ashkari turned to a laborer for aid and noticed for the first time the heavy gloves and coat she wore. As she tended to him, the Ashkari asked them why she was dressed so in such style. To avoid your fate, she replied. But there are many thousands of bees here, the Ashkari said to her, and only one stung me. Surely your caution is unwarranted. The stinger is always a surprise, agreed the laborer. But so is the bee that simply passes one by.
What the Kunari do goes beyond caution, though.
Look around you. Ask the dead who lie here what the cost of one mage's failure is. We should not linger here.
Let's go.
As you wish.
Is there another conversation I can get with Morgan before I head out?
Your desire? So, full of questions, are you?
So Flemeth is dead. What now?
Now I have enough time to study Mother's grimoire to find a way to prevent her from stealing my body in the future. For she will be back. One day, I have no doubt of that. And if I cannot protect myself, one day I will track her down again in whatever body she inhabits, and she will die again and again if need be. But there is no need to think of such things now. I have you to thank for saving me, so let us return to the task of dealing with the Darkspawn, no?
I will always protect you, Morgan.
You should not be so... You have no idea what will happen in days to come to make such promises. Let us go. There is much to be done before... There is still much to be done.
Can I get you a ladder so you can get off my...
Shut the fuck up.
Yes.
You sassy asshole. Take Morgan.
Indeed.
And screw it, yes. I'll take Severin. Hashtag. Get something done during this video. I think I remember where I get Catriel's grasp. Don't you get it from Gorim later in the game? It's one of the things that become available. Okay, first, prep a clash. Nope, nothing.
I shall do it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sounds better than later. Can I get to the ladder? Are you gonna get off my back? Got it.
Go. So be it.
Blood sacrifice. It takes a little bit of your ally's health and restores so much of your own. And now,
bravo!
For a little extra bit of nastiness, blood control.
Shall we compete for points?
I wonder if there's a tactic that for blood mage.
Your desire?
To get out of my way and let me loop this shriek. Okay, now let's see. Healer. Porter controller. Custom. Okay, I can actually modify this. Self. Any. Activate mode. Blood magic. Drain life is useless for someone constantly using blood magic. So, health at 50. Use blood sacrifice. Of course, I could have just modified that for that, but anyway. Enemy. I'm trying to set. Okay, nearest visible mage. Use ability. Mana clash. What else can I do? I don't want to set a tactic that will utilize blood control, because that can get annoying, actually, if she just automatically uses it on an enemy that we're trying to kill. So let me see. Okay, this should be good. So I got set to where she's always got blood magic and frost weapons activated. When enemies clustered with at least three creatures, she'll use blood wound. And if she gets to 50% health, she'll use blood sacrifice. Nearest visible, lightning and winter's grasp. Not too sure about that one. That'll be fine, because she'll be healing herself. And with the nearest visible mage, she'll use Mana Clash. There we go. Maybe now I won't have to control her to use Mana Clash anymore. Okay, and this way. Yeah.
This is it. Kadash Tig.
This is where you're from?
Perhaps. It may also be where I was found. These ruins are always overrun by vermin. There may be something noteworthy further in, however.
Alright, let's go.
Was this the home once? Did I live here?
Let's save game, though. I don't want to get goobered. As I am wont to do. Okay, set to hard. Just check.
Twisted creatures. Get on it.
Blood mages are ridiculously powerful. I hope the next game they bring it back as a specialization. Sorry, but why are you not? Let me just check your tactics real quick. Nearest visible mage, use Mana Clash. Oh, enemy clustered with at least two creatures. Okay.
Better than later.
What? No more? Oh.
What? No more? Oh. Blood-gorged amulet. Flawless natural crystal. That had nothing. Okay, Zevra, I'm trying to prove your worth. You're worth something!
I see nothing. Whatever was once here is gone.
Be considered clustered together.
Hurry.
I'm beginning to think that the Dragon Age Origins AI isn't smart enough to utilize blood magic with tactics. Because I just saw her try to use a blood sacrifice and she didn't target anyone, no one, nothing happened.
Poking me.
I'm not poking you. Oh my eye.
A beast. Let's maul it.
Oh, that's lovely.
What is your command?
Pray for no creature.
Pigeons.
There are no pigeons here. Blech.
dark spawn. Kill them all. Now it's better.
Immobilized with the blood magic.
I cannot be defeated.
Yeah, I just had him open that. Or I just opened that. Dippy-doo. Who is this ever actually takes the time to use the arrow in this game? They're so useless. I tried utilizing them in one playthrough, I kept forgetting I even fucking had them.
Alright, alright.
Oh, so that's how far they gotta be before you'll do it.
You just attack you. You can get off my back. Now is better than later.
Watching in horror as I rip you apart! That's right, come on!
Bravo! Yeah, that's right.
I'll get on it.
I still remember.
Now she's starting to use her tactics.
Can I get you a ladder so you can get off my back?
Sovereigns. So far, I've gotten one natural, flawless natural crystal. That's it.
I'm uncertain what I hope to find here.
It's saving my content. There must be something big. Certainly sounds angry.
Fun, no? Your order.
All right.
Well, it's being damaged by the blood wound, but it's just not paralyzed by it.
All right.
Watch in horror as I rip you apart.
Everin, you guard that rear. You guard Morgan's ass. Or yours is will be mine. And not the way you wanted it to be when you asked me to join you in to join me in my game. To massage.
Got
crystals here. Small flawless ice crystal. Small flawless nature. Dead Tig Shanka. Flawless lightning. I already have one of those actually. Golem monument.
What is this? This I remember. It has dates and names. This is to honor those who volunteered, those who became golems. And there is my name, Shale of House Kadash. Just as Carradine said. I remember now. I remember, Shale. That was me.
You remember? That's wonderful.
Wonderful to remember being a soft, squishy creature of flesh. Perhaps. I will need to think on these things I have learned. Perhaps I will speak to it of them soon. For now, let us carry on as we have.
Shale approves by 23.
Your desire?
To loot the shriek. Thank you. So let's see what I got out of that. Well, besides a gift for
I'm
Shale.
I'm to keep this, am I? Fine.
Let's see, I have a large flawless lightning crystal. Oh. Large flawless nature crystal. And a large flawless spirit crystal. Weapon-wise, I have a small flawless ice, lightning, and nature. I do not have a flawless fire or spirit crystal. And I do not have a large flawless ice or fire. Crap, they're all supposed to be here. Aren't they? This is supposed to be where you go to get Shale's good stuff. And he's attacking your hoodie. He's attacking the string on your hoodie. Okay. Yeah, what the hell? This ain't gonna take too long. I'll go to Lake Callenhad, put Oghren in my party, take care of him, then I'll be done. La da da do, la da da do, la da da do, da abracadabra, butthead, Krakatoa, Artichoke.
Pigeon crap.
Okay, I'm trying to remember what the trick is here. I think it's just to make him sound as good as possible. I think that's what helps him out.
There she is. I'm gonna go talk to her. Look, you gotta back me up here. Got it?
What do you mean? What do you mean, back you up?
Just follow my lead, you know?
Let me go talk to her first. She might be married now.
Hadn't thought of that. Find out how much she misses old Oghren or who I have to kill, and then I'll go sweep her off her feet. That's me, Mr. Charm.
If only you knew the ladies as well as you knew ale.
What can I get for you? And don't say mead. We ran out of that a week ago. And don't say rum, either. Ran out the day before yesterday. And don't say brandy.
When did you run out of brandy?
Oh, we haven't yet. It's just terrible. We got it from a shady Orlesian trader, and I think it might really be turpentine.
Felsi! I need tables clean, girl!
I've got a customer!
Your name's Felsi?
Aye. Who wants to know?
You don't happen to know a fellow named Oghren, do you?
Ugh, did you have to bring his name up? I just ate.
So you're not exactly a fan of his, then?
You could say that. You could also say I would rather kiss a Deepstalker on the lips than see him again.
What happened between you two?
What happened? Is that a serious question? Have you met Oghren? He got drunk. Drunker than usual, even. Took off his pants and challenged a roast nug to a wrestling match at my father's funeral. He lost, by the way. The roast got him in an arm lock. He sat there crying for a half an hour before someone pulled it off him.
How did he lose to a piece of meat?
It was a sodding good roast.
Felsi, what in Andraste's name are you doing? The tables, girl!
All right! I've got to get back to work.
Hello, Oghren, who was supposed to be waiting over there.
Well, what does she say?
She hasn't exactly forgiven you for the nug incident.
Yeah, that fight was rigged. Anyway, the guards said it wasn't worth pressing charges, so she's no call to hold a grudge. Did she say anything else?
Go get her.
Just be ready to pry her off when she throws herself at me. We don't want to make a scene here. Well, don't pry her off me too soon. I mean, a little scene's all right. You sure you're not a baker? Because you got a sodding nice set of buns.
Well, look what the nug dragged in. I should have known you were in the neighborhood, by the stench. What are you doing here?
Just trying to kick back with a pint. Fighting Darkspawn's a lot of sodding work, you know?
You're fighting Darkspawn?
This man took on an army of golems almost single-handed.
It was a bit of pain, but it was a personal favor for the King of Orzammar, you understand?
The whole surface to choose from, and you just happened to come to my tavern?
Tell her it's fate.
What? Oh, right. It's fate, Felsi. What can I say?
Fate? The ancestors must have a sense of humor, then.
Sure they do. You've had a good look at Lady Helmy, haven't you? If her face isn't a joke the ancestors are playing, I'm a Bronto's behind.
So, Lady Helmy must be a paragon of beauty, then.
Tell her you've been thinking of her.
I've been thinking about you, Felsi.
What do you want, Oghren?
Nothing. Just thought I'd see how you were doing is all. Well, maybe that and grease up the Bronto, if you know what I mean.
Well, you've seen me. You'll have to go back to Orzammar for the Bronto.
Do I go with two or three? I want this to end well. I can't remember.
They both end well, so it doesn't.
Okay. Admit it, Oghren's much more fun than the men around here.
If by fun you mean more likely to light farts on fire, yes.
Oh well, it's been fun, Felsi, but I better go.
Wait, you're leaving? You just got here. I haven't called you a shaft rat yet.
Well, you can't keep the archdemon waiting. You hurt its feelings and might just turn the whole blight around and go home. Nobody wants that.
Well, you don't need to fight it right now, do you? I mean, you could have a pint first. You could call me a surly Bronto. I could tell you that you smell like nug droppings.
I'll tell you what, I got some things I gotta do, but I'll come back for that pint when things are settled, you frigid Deepstalker.
Fine, but you better not keep me waiting, you worthless copper-plated swordcast.
Wouldn't dream of it.
Yes, apparently part of their charm as a couple was insulting each other.
I still got it.
Yeah, you do still have it on your head. I mean, goddamn, what is with that glitch? Wait, that was a success? Are you sure?
Weren't you watching? She could barely restrain herself. Might as well rest up while I can. You ready to go?
Let's go.
Aye. All right, then.
Alrighty, so with that, I'm gonna cut it. When I come back to this, I'm going to Redcliffe to get things started for the finale. Oh, there's still some crap I gotta do. Anywho, thank you guys so much for watching, as always. I'll see you in the next episode. Later!